Hello friends, I'm gonna turn this way most of the video because I have some really bad acne over here.
Hello, welcome to a history project featuring England and what they accomplished during the Age of Exploration along with my good old buddy Francis Drake. LOL, this is gonna be a fun time.
England, they're all snobs, right? Well, I mean, probably. Fun fact segment, did you know England was arguably the most advanced civilization during the Age of Exploration? Did you know? England is pretty lame, I guess. White people. So during the Age of Exploration, England wasn't in the best shape. There was this thing called the Black Death. It was basically like a cold, except it wasn't. And you know, death, blah, 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 fleas, blah, 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 black, whatever. There was also this thing called the Hundred Years' War with France, and the whole monarchy was being challenged. Food shortages, economic collapse, population increase, rapid degeneration. So basically, the Queen of England, her name was Elizabeth I, decided to promote the merchants and sailors of England to roam the New World in search of gold, wonders, and maybe a few civilizations to destroy. Totally kidding. They aren't the Spanish Empire. Fun fact segment, did you know Spain was responsible for the collapse of many early American civilizations? Wow. Nice. So England attempted to discover like a better way to get to Europe, and the Ottoman Empire was like cutting off some route to Asia and everything. Everything was bad. To avoid a lot of conflict with the Spanish, who was a major controller of the seas at the time, they basically went looking for spices instead of useful things. But then again, like, salt is needed for, like, meat or something to keep it fresh, so I guess it was useful. So what are some major accomplishments from England? England's early endeavors in the Western Hemisphere never reached the caliber of those like Spain and France, but included the following major ventures. John Cabot was sent by Henry VIII in 1497 to search for the Northwest Passage to India. He cruised coastal Newfoundland and noted the excellent fishing opportunities along the Grand Banks. England flourished and the profits from wool traded thanks to the Grand Banks, but their religious system was all out of whack, so they didn't do much else around the area. That's sad. Martin Frobisher conducted 3 voyages to the New World in the years from 1576 to 1578. He tried to find the Northwest Passage but didn't find anything,
so nobody cared about him.
John Davis explored the Northwest waters and promised there wasn't any monsters and mean people in the waters below. In 1583, Humphrey Gilbert, a prominent soldier and crown favorite, led an effort to establish the first English colony in America, which lasted like 10 minutes.
In the mid-1580s, Walter Raleigh sponsored attempts to establish a permanent colony in the new area of Virginia. You know, like the first permanent settlement from English in the New World, you know, the place, Virginia, I'm sure you've heard of it. The 13 original colonies.
Overall, these efforts were not successful. The English were far behind when it comes to discovery in the Age of Exploration. However, 2 positive things came out of this. Like I said previously, religion was all crazy over in England during this era. Not a fun time if you didn't believe the exact same way the public did. So, all these awesome people endured hard conditions on the seas to establish some religious freedom in the New World. We all see how that worked out today. New forms of business organization developed, which provided sufficient funding for the establishment of colonies. Let's get to the super fun segment where we interview a sailor-pirate during this time period. Francis Drake!
Now let's bring out old Francis Drake. We have brought him back from the depths of the underworld for a special and exciting time. And let's get to it, shall we?
Wait, what? I'm so confused right now.
Shh, I ask the questions here.
I'm actually so confused right now.
Awesome! So question number 1, what's your name?
Francis.
Your last name too.
Are you going to my social security number?
Awesome! So when were you born?
Yes. I don't really remember, like 1540 or something. I was born in Tavistock, Devon, England.
I didn't ask that!
I just assumed that.
And your accent isn't even good. And what is that stupid umbrella on your head for?
I got it in the invasion of Panama.
Alright, that's a lie. They sell the exact same ones at Bahama Bucks. You're a barbarian.
I have a bandana. Pirates wear bandanas.
No, those are cowboys, you idiot.
Go England. You wanna ask the next question?
Listen, buddy, I get paid by the question here.
So let me ask this question, and you sit your freezing stout answer.
We didn't bring you back from the dead for you to be annoying, Francis. Dang.
Well, freaking hey. Sorry.
Awesome! Next question. So what are some of your greatest accomplishments?
Well, in 1577, I circumnavigated the entire planet. Bet you didn't see that one coming.
Wow.
I was knighted, became a member of Parliament, purchased Buckland Abbey, defeated the whole entire Spanish Armada, not once, but twice. Or defeated the whole entire Spanish Armada 2 times.
I hear you're very rich. How rich?
Well, on your stand is about $126 million. I'm the second richest pirate ever, according to Forbes. That ding dang Samuel Bellamy had to take me out. Oh, I am so annoyed. Oh. Freaking dang it, man. I am not Jamaican.
Well, Pirates of the Caribbean, am I right?
This is 2015.
Are you saying the movie's irrelevant now?
I'm saying that you need to get your art together because you're the interviewer here and you need to be on pop culture, not I.
I'm from 1542 and I know about more pop culture than you. 1542! Stop! Okay! My friends is Drake, I'm gonna do that.
We're getting to the end here. Any last things you want to say?
I am cool.
Okay, well, how did you die exactly?
What a rude question.
No, seriously.
I'd rather not talk about it.
Francie!
Okay. Well, I invaded Puerto Rico, and I got really overzealous, and this ding-dang cannonball like went right through my flagship and grazed my sleeping quarters. And I mean, I was alright for a little bit, but then I got bing-binged and I died of dysentery. So, yeah, it was really bad. Because dysentery is not good. No good for you.
Okay, well, can you clarify what that is? What is dysentery?
Basically, I got a really bad bloody diarrhea and,
That's enough! That's Francis Drake for you!
Like, I have really bad blood.
Alright, that's Francis Drake for you!
My sheets went through the underwall.
Stop! Francis!
It was so heavy.
Now he wants to talk about it.
It was so heavy. The world was demagnetized. Demagnetized, I tell you.
This video was really bad, and I'm sorry. Thanks for watching. I'm sure half of you weren't really paying attention. Like, I'm sure Paige and Toy were on their phones. I'm sure Juan was probably sleeping. I'm sure Austin was probably, like, playing that stupid football game on his phone or writing a paper over something annoying. And I'm sure Allie. Never mind, guys. Bye.